This is the song that plays on the Runaway Guys Play Your Game!
So this is it. My destiny is in that hole.
That's what he said.
Hey, you can't do that. Only girls can do that.
Oh, God. 59 minutes.
Wait, what?
Hey, there's your sister. Sister, she's just on the ground. Just pick up the ground and you can go home.
So I just gotta ground pound the 2D switch and she just appears, right?
Yeah, that's about right.
Oh. All right.
Well,
here
we go.
Okay, so I remember a little bit of this. Welcome all, Grunty's the name. Banjo's here to play my game.
Mm-hmm.
My lair is done and here he stands. Through all my tricks and traps and lands. This final test will see me win. Then Banjo fails, then I'll be thin. The prizes on this stand bring joy from Tootie down to Cuddly Toy. My little quiz will make you sweat. And Tootie you shall never get. Cause somewhere soon along the way, your lack of skill will make my day. Cause in the fiery pit you'll go, and I will win the prize on show. So step on over to the square. Press A to try it if you dare. Wow, they overdid it with the rhymes.
I was gonna say, that's a lot longer than I remember it being.
Yeah, she said like, cause this, cause that, because of this. Freeze Easy Slalom Course is a crass. Do you know how many gates through?
Oh my god,
what?
Ooh, coming out swinging, let's go, Grunty First Fight.
28? No! That is a mean question! Fail a square and you'll feel pain. Please press A to try again.
Yeah, sure.
So she just subtracts the health from you, there's no
attack.
Felt
pain from the poison.
No.
Planker's cavern really stinks. His massive chain. How many? What?
Yes.
Wow, the game is swinging today.
Dude. Yes. Coming out swinging like Captain Strong. No, that's wrong.
We've already both made Earthbound references.
Wow. The walrus on Freeze Easy Peak. What's
his name? How many tusks, you geek?
Waza.
Oh, I was about to say.
That one is right.
See the picture on my screen. Do you know where you have been? That's Treasure Trove Cove. Easy.
Nice, all right.
Okay, it's loosening up a little
bit. These are my
bit.
Favorites.
Okay, yeah. So I remember this very slightly. I do remember that there was like a quiz show at the end called Furnace Fun. Going into this for the first time, I was aware that there was something at the end of the game called Furnace Fun. I knew one person who had told me about it, and they described it as the most awful piece of shit that ruined an otherwise great game.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah, I knew somebody who, like, hyped this up as just really bad. Oh, crap, I wasn't really paying attention.
Which one's not true? In Bubble Gloop Swamp?
Two crocodiles. I thought there were more.
There's the
yeah,
big
no,
one,
I,
and then
I thought
you.
This thing was awesome, but I can see if you keep getting stuck on it, because it is fairly long, that bothering you. Mm-hmm. And, when so you didn't
no,
know
no,
about it at all in the first
oh, no.
recording. Dan,
I
if you still have the audio, Dan, can you mix in what his immediate reaction was to figuring out what this was? Because I remember it being really funny.
This is
it's a game show!
I've always wanted to be on Throne Controllers! I like how she has time for this while doing dangerous experiments. I cannot even hear
that. Oh, that sounded like bottles.
I think that was... Okay.
That was a Jinjo.
Oh,
no!
Man!
That's my fault.
It's okay. Listen up now, then make your choice. Okay. Trigger has the stupid double. That's definitely bottles.
Okay,
that's definitely
bottles. Yeah.
I think I might turn up my TV just because it's really... Beakers the Mole and Jam Jar. One of the fake fake nicknames for Kazooie is on there.
Gee, I wonder where this is.
Belly
nice panty shot of this guy.
Yeah, man. I got
that
some nice panty shots
Bubble
of
Gloop
Pyro.
Swamp. Thank you.
Nice.
I really do like those. And not just because I like that guy.
They're screenshots, by the way. No, I'm not looking
Spiral
that up
Mountain,
or anything.
Fields of Green, which veggie baddie isn't seen.
Uh-oh.
Topper the carrots. No potatoes.
No potatoes?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
No potatoes.
prepare yourself to take a whack. Pick this test. You won't come back.
Time attack.
Oh, shoot!
Yes!
The tiles await for you to match. Time is- I figured that it was like a lightning round. I'm just thinking of this like thrown controllers.
Mm. Nope, it is literally a speed challenge.
Hey, whoa, whoa, nice!
Nice. Speaking of Gaha, we've been watching these Mickey Mouse cartoons on Disney Plus.
They're really funny.
They're pretty good. I'm liking it.
Oh no, it's those the more modern ones?
Yes.
Like it says the like 2013. Ones?
Yeah, they're really funny and like meme-y. It's like the one where he's like, "I'm so obsessed with you." That one. It's really hard to recommend to people because the show is literally just called Mickey Mouse. So like searching it out is kind of hard. But yeah, it's really funny. I think Disney realized that, like, no kids were watching Mickey Mouse cartoons nowadays. They had to do something to make them care, and so that was their answer. Oh my god, one
nicely
try!
Done, wow. With time to spare.
Nice!
8 seconds left, too.
Boo!
I can't whistle! I'm trying to whistle, and I can't...
How well do you remember?
How can I not... I was trying to go like, woo, but I can't whistle right now. What the hell? There we
Sometimes
go, there we
just
go.
Can't.
I think it's time, so let me see. Oh, no, crap! I'm not pretty, I'm quite a mess. What do I hide under my dress? Oh, these are the- oh,
yes.
Gosh.
Yeah.
These are the Brentilda things. Massive bloomers? No.
No. Yeah, that's what I would've picked too. I don't
God,
remember.
I've heard about this. Jules told me that this was the reason why people didn't run the game for a long time, though, but now there's a glitch that allows you to manipulate what the answers are, so that they're always the same. The newsstand is where I've been. What's my favorite magazine? I think it was like Fat Hag, yeah, Fat Hag Monthly. Big Butts and Guts?
Hell yeah, man.
What?
Let's go Big Butts and Guts.
Whoa.
I should know my waifu better than that.
Oh my god, are you actually calling girls your waifu at this point?
Cross I glide, what type of broomstick do I ride? The Lard Master 2000.
The Lard
The
Master.
Rough Rider, that's really funny. Let's
Billy
go.
Mays here with the Lard Master 2000.
What for breakfast do I eat? Tadpoles on toast, spider pancakes, or rat...
I think
I said tadpoles on toast? No. I'm trying to remember like all those times where I'm like, Grunty said that she likes the number 7 and all that.
I think it was spider pancakes, actually.
What color undies do I wear?
Oh, brown, probably.
Yeah, streaky brown, I think. Sweaty yellow.
Hmm.
No!
Oh, dear me. Ooh,
I get one more chance. You know what? If I got like only one health left, I might as well Joker it.
Yeah.
And then this one is a hardy, I'm pretty sure.
If you lose this one, you die immediately, no matter how much health you have.
Yeah. Damn, I'm going straight to another grunty square, though, is the problem.
I mean, you could go left.
I could. I need to turn up my TV. Hang on. So I can actually hear this.
Yeah, go for it.
Note.
Your note wrong.
I know when Jules runs this game, there's a glitch he does where he makes it so that he can just run around the board freely and just run past it all.
Oh, yeah. I know that, like, it's something that lets you get pretty grim. How many hoops did you... Oh,
wow,
gosh.
What's with all the how many's here?
Less than 7.
8. Well done.
8 is correct.
It's always 8 red something you gotta do in these platformers. It even happens in Splatoon. Picture of a screen to know where you've been. That is Clanker's Cavern, I think.
I think you're right.
Aw, nap night.
Clanker's Cavern.
Nice.
Clanker's Cavern.
And I have to do another Gruntilda. Oh, God. I get 2 health if I do it. It's all these spells I land. Whom at school was my best friend? Saggy Maggie. I know this one.
Yep.
You
screamed that one so much, I knew you would never forget that one.
There we go.
Thank you, you're too kind. Hey, I got 2. Man, what a bunch of jokers.
Oh my god. Jeez.
Mad
Monster
Question.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, the slow organ. What stage could that be?
Well, I don't know. Where could it possibly be from?
Rusty Monster Bay, definitely.
Rusty Monster Bay.
Rusty Monster Bay.
You furry goon reminds me of the hairy fool. Okay, well, we're
that's
back up on
health.
Let's
get the health
nice.
Back now. Yeah, that's good.
Treasure Trove Cove.
Take a dump on the toilet. It smells so bad because I want my butt in when I'm done. I don't fart now. That didn't make any sense.
Treasure Bucket Bay.
Well. Huh.
Bling. Yay. Oh boy, mini game time.
All right, let's see what you got this
going
time.
For
get
it.
A solo video game challenge.
Oh, here we go.
No! Are you
here
kidding?
We go. Stings that make a bear shout. Whack them all before time runs out.
What is this? I don't even get hell from this. Oh god, I was Chuck Norrising it there for a while, but no more.
But no more.
Oh god, no.
Yeah.
He remembered this time. He had some left and he remembered.
Yay.
I was just trying. Oh, no. Oh! He got me anyway. I was thinking one left that'll be easy.
There we go.
So that challenge specifically stonewalled him the entire time last time. He died on that one like five separate times because he had no Wonder Wing feathers left and he just could not get the timing down. It was rough.
Do you know, and can you tell, what on earth's my favorite smell?
Gasoline.
Putrid parrot pooch, sweaty, I think it's sweaty gorilla. No, freshly burst boils.
Yeah,
we talked
I think
about
that's
that.
What it is.
Yep,
nice,
that's the one.
Nice, all right.
Nice. I don't know why I'm saying nice about that.
You're almost there.
I like them fried. Oh, this one again. So we thought it was the pancakes and not tadpoles on toast.
Yeah.
Spider pancakes.
There you go.
Power pancakes, baby.
They benefit real spiders when you buy them.
And they clap along to the music.
Yeah, they're so good. Minigame time, please don't hurt me.
What's it gonna be?
Yes!
Oh no!
Oh, I was hoping for this, baby.
No! Yes!
It's time for the learning curve. Does he remember how to win against Mr. Vile? With the shoes, he's got a good chance, and with the rubber banding, another good chance. However, the game
Anything
is full
is
of
possible.
Spite.
Game is full of spite, but do you have the fight?
And he gets
it.
Wow, you kind of annihilated him there.
Oh, I was shaking that whole time. Oh. I think it was the spinning fan blades. There's a sled on their own. No.
Oh, shoot. It's coming down to
Bubble
it.
Bubble Gloop Turtle Choir is swell, but what's on the back of each shell? A bigger turtle? Musical note.
Okay.
That's a good fake answer. I like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Go Joker yourself. Okay. I have to remember one thing about my waifu. Remember now, before you lose, what type toothpaste do I use? Tuna salted slug.
He's got it.
Yeah.
He first tried it. Incredible.
B. Oh my god,
Get
y'all.
Get out of here, you ugly prototype.
Incredible.
Oh, no one can win, I was assured, by the makers of this board. It's not fair. I want to win. How I long to be real thin. Now you can take the prize on show. While up the winding stairs I go! You won't catch me. I've made sure. All the credits you'll now endure.
Oh,
I like
man.
How it's canon that she hired a board game company to design this for her. Like she hired like Mattel or somebody. Which prize should I do? Oh, go for the washing machine! Go for the washing machine! The washing machine!
The doll, the doll, the doll!
The star prize thing that you stand on.
That grotty ugly thing. I think we should take Tootie. No, no! That's what I meant. Kazooie!
Can we go home? I've had enough adventuring for one day, despite being in the one place for the entire time you were doing
so
things.
So much adventuring inside of that tiny little machine.
I've been sitting in a closet all day. I want to go home and play Game Boy. So what'd you think of the game?
Well, it was quite wonderful. I stand by not liking the hub world and thinking it's annoying to navigate and a lot of things look the same. The actual levels, you know, some of the best on the system, some of the best gameplay on the system. I liked all the different moves. I will say I was a little disappointed when they're like, hey, each world we're gonna teach you a new move, and I'm like, wow, I wonder like what our moveset's gonna look like by the end of this game, but really all the actual moves are in like the first half hour of the game, and then after that it's just, oh, the floor is lava. Get yourself some better feet that don't get hurt by the lava.
Yeah.
So, those are my complaints, though, but a lot of personality, a lot of fun characters. It's fun flying around. It's fun using all the moves. It's very simple, knows what it wants to be, very good. Surprisingly brutal at times. I still say that I can't believe my 8-year-old cousins actually finished this, because as an adult, I had trouble with certain parts. What do you guys think?
I love it. I got it right when it came out. Like, I went to Best Buy, and they had this game on display to play. I hope I haven't told this story already, but like, they just had it on display. I had never heard of it before, and I just played it for like 5 minutes, and I was like, I want this game, so I just got it.
Grant Kirko.
Grant Q-Cope. Yeah.
For me, I played it at my cousin's place. He rented it, and like, we went through the majority of the game. We got up to Rusty Bucket Bay, and then we got stuck there on the engine room one. And like, we had a great time, so like, I wanted it so bad, but I'm like, I also beat most of the game, so I don't think there's any point in me getting it. So I borrowed it off of a friend when he ended up getting it and beat it that way, and then Tui was the game I ended up owning and playing when I grew up. But like, I still like Kazooie more. It's got complaints, but I think otherwise it's a pretty solid game.
I think you said your opinion of Tui's been going up lately after seeing it again.
My opinion of Tui's been going up a bit, yeah. It's still got some like, oh my god, why did you choose to do this things, but like, it is, I've gotten softer on it than since I started that playthrough with Reese.
Yeah, I have a friend who describes it as bigger, better, and worse. And I think from what I've heard, I think that's kind of funny. Could always consider Tui for me, I guess.
I'm curious to see how you would feel about it.
Yeah, like, if you like the moves in this game, they go completely off the charts with the next one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I know you
start with all the moves from this game. Like, the game starts with you be like, all right, you know everything, go.
Yeah, I've heard of that you start with all the moves. Speaking of that, okay, people always get, like, so mad about all, like, the hand-wavy explanations for why Samus doesn't have her powers from the previous Metroid game. Would anybody actually care or notice at all if they just didn't acknowledge it and just were like, yeah, you just don't have any of your powers?
I mean, usually that's what they do. Or they're like, yeah, you didn't bring everything.
Okay, because, like, usually they have explanations for why you can't use your powers. I mean, there's the whole, like, infamous, like, having to be authorized to use your powers, or, like, oh no, like, you lost a fight with Ridley and now you don't have them anymore because he destroyed them all or something.
Some of the reasons they give in-game are stupid. Like, Metroid Prime 1 has the cutscene where you just kind of get slammed against a wall.
Yeah,
and it's like, okay, you've had worse hits. How the hell did that cost you half your powers?
Yeah. I'm just like, would anybody actually care if you just started the game without the powers and they never acknowledged it? Because I thought that was generally an expected thing for games. Ooh, Nabnut. Hurry up and get us home, Banjo. I'm going as fast as I can. Hey, look over there. We missed a carrot.
Aw, yeah.
Got him. Are you happy now?
Are you happy now?
This is totally just they recorded the inputs and they wrote that in because it was funny.
Yeah, that's exactly what they did.
Oh my gosh. Ooh, we're having a barbecue.
Oh my god, I love it.
I like your call out of calling the stingers in Salmon Run cookouts. That's fun. A lot of people said they're gonna start adapting your call outs for Salmon Run after we did that video.
Nice.
Baron Burgett Good helped Mumbo do something. Hey,
Meanwhile, the goldfish is being barbecued.
Yeah, it's still alive and it's Banjo's goldfish.
Jeez. Here's the thing. That's a running gag.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
That goldfish is just always getting hurt somehow.
He's in the
What's
sequel.
The party for
him?
Runny got away, so get back up there and finish the job. Oh yeah, that's right. We never did that.
It's a square.
Do
mouth.
We really need to hurt her? We got what we wanted, and she's awesome.
I'm bringing the glass with me.
Okay, good. They at least have the common decency to spawn you back here. Hey, ladies, I'll have you know, I'm a prize.
All right,
well, now you gotta play as Tootie, and Tootie has to save you.
Jeez.
Man, it's just like Xenoblade. If you can see it, you can actually go there.
Yup.
Xenoblade 3 is this weekend, and I am finishing this and finishing Splatoon 2 in time for it.
Aw, yeah. I'm still working on Torno, and I'm almost there.
Yeah. You do have Future Connected.
Yes, I do.
I'm playing number one!
It's okay, son. You'll come of age eventually.
Uh-huh. Is that what it is? Number one is just growing up. Number two is puberty, hence all the boobs. And number three is like the you're out of college, starting your real life one.
More like, but no, number three is like when you're drafted into the military against your will.
Ooh.
Okay.
Because like I know three is all about soldiers at least, and like the whole, you know, like fighting to live, living to fight whole thing. That's like the first line in the trailer. Lots of jiggies make it complete.
I love that picture, by the way. Just...
Yeah, she looks so menacing and cool.
Yeah, she does.
Tell me, would you not want, like, a fine piece of this?
I should paint that.
Yeah. I'm good.
Oh.
Not my type.
Also, I'm like puberty, more like booberty.
Booberty.
Oh, wow!
That's a big-ass feather.
Yep.
Dude, that is like a king's feather.
Yeah, and not only that, it fills you up completely.
Oh.
Mm.
And then full. These models are made of sex. They are like the most beautiful N64 models
Jesus.
I've ever seen.
I'm putting that on Twitter.
These are really good looking models, man. Like, they're so smooth and silky and like Rouge the Bat.
That took a direction I didn't expect. Okay.
That's what the lyrics say in the song, so like I just actually it's just sexy and smooth.
Didn't know she was your type. Now we're learning. Now we're learning.
Man, I'm just naming everyone my wife for today. John, are you available?
No.
Wow.
Tim?
Anyways, really? You might have just noticed you just got double the health.
These are like the nicest models in a Nintendo 64 game I've ever seen, other than maybe like Toad on the Mario Tennis main menu. We'll sort her out if you can find us a way up there.
No Revengeance.
Problem. Just splosh on it. Oh gosh, I get to bathe in her vomit!
Why are you so excited sounding about that?
It's like having a piece of her with me. I don't know.
I mean,
I'll stop. Let's just go up. I'm being weird.
Yeah,
I tell you, she puked in me. It was awful.
Enjoy that smell.
I can't believe that furry pair got right up here. It's so unfair. But now the stupid bear must fight. This battle tests your skill and might.
So this is the first thing I ever saw of this game, like I told you. My cousin fought this fight in front of me. She hangs, and she bangs, and she sputters. Oh boy!
She bangs, and she rides a broom.
Going over.
She moves out there to murder you.
That's pretty good.
Okay, that was good.
There you go.
Nice, she moves. I'll grab the health.
She moves. Why are we suddenly singing that now? Or maybe it's just me, I don't know.
He's maybe because Ricky Martin's in the news.
He actually is, yeah, I saw that. Ugh, it's unfortunate.
Not for good reasons, yeah.
Oh.
Guess they should have called him Dickie Martin.
Whoa.
No.
This is always the part I found.
Oh,
yeah, there it is. I knew it happened at least once.
Okay.
I feel like that is a tradition. That's a hazing ritual. It has to happen to every player at some point.
Oh gosh.
So there's a specific type of cheat. In the game, there are regular cheats that like Cheeto gives you. Those are fine, but there are a bunch that you can get online and type in the word cheat to activate. Those are the ones that give you access to the stop and swap eggs in the N64 version and other stuff like that. Apparently, if you type in too many of those, that causes an issue. I don't know if this is true. I saw this in the comments again. I don't know if this is true. Typing in three of those cheats on a save file in the Xbox version deletes your save. I do not know
if that's true,
but I could believe it, and that's hilarious if that's true.
That is so mean.
That could also be the N64 one, but either way, that's really funny if that's true, but it's a bonus cheat that's in Nintendo Power or something like that.
Damn.
The actual cheats, you're safe to use. And in at least in Tui's case, like any cheats you find along the way are safe to use, but if you have to type Cheeto to activate them, that disables saving and achievements.
Oh, damn. It does seem relative to which direction I'm facing. Whoa!
Gotta go on that one.
Slid forward more than I thought I was going to.
Yeah.
Here we go.
And there it is.
Again!
I'm seeing some rhymes here that I've never seen before.
Are you ready this time, Brit? Shut up! Are you actually gonna do it this time, or are you just gonna suck again? Cause like, I don't know,
I don't want her to come down and beat me up, you know, cause you actually do your job.
Okay. In we go.
Dip, dip.
Third time.
Third time's a charm. Hey, the more times you have to try, the more puke you get on you.
Yeah. I mean, that's not so bad, right?
Let's break for ourselves.
We both be toast.
Well.
She acknowledges that she's like Sans before Sans was Sans.
Oh my god, yeah.
Has anybody done a Photoshop of Prince of Persia Sands of Time, but with Sans from Undertale on it?
Probably. I'm looking it up.
Please.
Well, surely there's
that's one thing I'm actually happy about looking up.
It's not in the Google search results, so.
Wow.
Man, I just thought of a totally original joke no one else has ever thought of.
I never bothered learning if it was actually on a set pattern or not.
Yeah.
She's going a long time. Oh my god, Tim!
I just had to try to impress Grunty.
How dare you move in
I don't think she's paying attention at the moment.
No, probably,
probably
not.
Just trying not to die.
In winter, whoa, you were using it.
Oh, in winter I was flying? Oh, yeah, I guess that's right. Yeah.
She's like, watch me fly and pick my nose.
She's really not worried about you, I guess.
Pop!
Ooh!
Ooh, you sniveling little pup! With this bolt, I'm speeding up. Bop! Right in the face!
Oh man, right in the forehead. Yeah.
I'm not gonna get that. Sorry. Oh, whoa. Oh, you don't fall instantly. Nice. I actually thought you would just spin out of control and die if that happened.
No, you do not, thankfully.
Thank God. Mm-hmm. See, Gruntilda's nice. She doesn't just senselessly murder you. She does it with reason. Oh, wow.
How the heck did you do that?
There is one way to make that happen, so be careful.
Okay.
Ah.
Nope, that's a miss.
Oh, she's so fast.
And that is the one way that you can kill yourself while flying.
Oh,
somehow
wow.
I knew it was going to happen. Somehow I knew.
You know me quite well.
Oh.
Hey, Banjo, you're looking glum. It must be hard being so dumb. Oh.
Damn.
Listen, you can mutilate my sister. You can, use slugs for toothpaste, but when you insult my intellect, that's when I try a little harder to kick your can.
Well, you heard
back
it here
once.
First.
That, yeah, you lost that one like at the beginning, I think.
Dude,
I don't think you ever really had that one in control.
It's a fun laugh. Wow, I thought I still had more to go on that phase, but
yeah, I moved
whatever.
Pretty fast. All right, let's try this suckage again.
Well, you're not pokey.
I do like how pokey actually does mean slow.
Yeah, and also like sharp.
Yeah, I didn't realize that. I thought they were called pokies because they were slow. I genuinely did, like before even the memes.
You didn't even think about like a poke with a needle or anything like that?
No, I just knew that pokey was a word that meant slow, and I was like, oh, I guess they are pretty slow, and like cactuses don't really move much, so you know, makes sense.
Ooh, right in the right.
Yeah,
butt
I sooner just thought they were called that because they were slow.
Soon you'll lose, and when you've gone, I have to go and use the John.
Oh god. You could probably just dive straight down and kill yourself too.
You can. You can also hit the world box there, but that won't kill you. That'll just make you take damage.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that was a good shot, though, man.
God, you think I died with how loud that was?
Yeah, I was like, you're not in trouble yet. Don't freak out that much.
Yet. Oh, no. All right, there we go. Now, I believe
this
is nothing
remaining.
I believe this is nothing that Grunty and I cannot work past. We have our differences, though, but they'll get resolved.
What you think we can work past, as long as I have this much gas.
Look at me, yeah. I'm quite a mess. I need a shield to hide my dress. Oh god, we have this now? Nice. Oh, that hurts you.
Wow.
Okay. Oh! Granny captures Jinjo's, now we've come for- Oh. Useless Jinjo sneer and hoot. Go right back right now or taste my boot.
Yeah, so you're done with flying for now.
Okay, oh, what?
Oh, wow.
Jeez, not
she's
if she
not gonna
that.
Let you land.
Oh!
Watch out on edges!
How?
I thought you were dead. I thought you were dead.
How?
Football! Oh, frick. She's hitting me.
No. It's, yeah, you could still die. You may have saved yourself just once, but next time, geez, you'll look like a dunce.
Cool it! Oh my gosh!
The fireball for another
she's
hit.
She's a little mad at you, I think.
Pretty soon,
she definitely thought you were supposed to be dead on that one.
Oh my god.
Oh man.
I'm almost out of health.
Uh-oh.
Oh, oh my god.
Oh wow, yeah, she's rough.
Oh my
god! Oh yeah!
God. Okay. I have two- No!
There's- this would be-
Oh no!
Oh.
How did she hit everything on that one? Like, jeez!
Yeah. She wanted you dead.
Dude, was she like aimbotting or something?
Oh man, it was getting to that point.
I think I'd have a better chance fighting dude in Splatoon rather than doing that, jeez.
I mean, to be fair, she was in the middle of the screen, like, she didn't have very hard to aim to kind of get you. Like, she could fire and it would only take a second for it to show up.
Man, like, yeah, she was just, every attack was just dead on.
Dead on, applied directly to the bear.
Have I ever told the story on the channel about how I lied my way through mandatory reading in elementary school?
Yes, but I don't know if that was in one of the lost recordings or not.
Oh, okay. I don't know if I should tell that or not. I guess I can, like, wait for feedback on that.
Bump, 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 bump.
I almost feel like that came up actually during the Gruntilda fight.
Huh.
That somehow would not shock me.
Because it's so evil that I wanted to do it to make Gruntilda like me.
Oh, look at that.
Right
wow.
In the kneecaps.
There we go. Jeez. Dropped health.
Every single body part.
I'm just trying to collect them all.
Well, that's so you.
That last shot I failed to stop, so down onto the ground I'll drop.
Yeah, down a reactor shaft.
Okay, at least this time I could see where they're coming from. The camera wasn't really, like, focusing on the boss there, so... Mm-hmm. I am the mighty Gingenator, this is Final Smash!
The great mighty Ginjo, yep. And I'm going to make you
Alright, welcome to the actually hard part, though.
Oh god. Wow, she is out for blood.
Yeah, I can't imagine why.
Yeah!
Oh my god.
Oh!
9 eggs left.
Oh my god. I wasn't even paying attention to the egg counter. I was just going. That probably would have added more attention if I was paying attention. Her biting her fingernails
attention,
when she sees
attention.
It.
By the way, did I mention?
This is how strong I aspire to be.
Woo!
Hey, that's my job to hit that. No, I'm kidding!
Wow.
Oh, wow.
I'm kidding! There's no way
DRG.
I'm going to sway!
Oh. I mean... How much more can she possibly take? All the humanity.
Plural Grunty set to follow up on the spell! Cast it! No, whoa! And she missed.
Oh, man. Yeah.
So, apparently, in the development, that was supposed to actually hit you, and it was supposed to transform Banjo and Kazooie into something, and then you had to play as Tootie and go collect the rest of the Mumbo tokens to transform Banjo and Kazooie back at the end of the game.
Are you serious?
Supposedly, that was the ending.
So, okay, I was already feeling like this finale felt a bit long, because, like, you got, like, the Furnace Fun and all those minigames and all that, and you could fail it quite a few times, potentially. And then, like, you got, like, a fake credits roll, and then it's like, oh, wait, we didn't do the final boss. Like, if they had that on, that ending would have been too long. But I guess that explains all the Mumbo, like, I think I heard, like, the Mumbo tokens, like, had a post-game originally or something. Like, I think you told
that,
me that
That
one.
Was the post-game, yeah.
Yeah.
Ah.
Oh, Jinjo. Hi.
Jinjo, so happy.
Aww. Hanging out at the beach with the Jinjo.
And here comes Boobalicious.
Casually walking around with her melons.
She's got melons in front of the other melons.
Yeah, apparently that was a censoring thing Nintendo asked for, because otherwise she was just walking around, you know, just showing the boob physics. So they put melons there to represent the melons that you can still see at different angles.
That's so much worse than if it was just normal. Like, I probably wouldn't have thought anything of that if I saw that as a kid if there weren't melons there.
And then Nintendo was just like, yeah, that's fine, go for it.
Oh god, Tim, I can smell you.
Oh no.
Oh, it's wafting over here.
It's wafting.
That's my
reward.
Oh
god, don't describe it. Oh, gross.
Yes, I suppose you are. Well done, Kazooie.
Kazooie MVP.
No more wows for you.
Thanks, Goggles, you're not so dumb after all. That's enough, Kazooie. Let's all watch the cast list now.
From the beat?
Wow.
Oh, they must have holographic projectors or something.
There you go. That is the end of the game. What'd you think?
Even though it was hard at times, I still really enjoyed it. Like, I liked being in Rusty Bucket Bay. I liked being in Mad Monster Mansion. I wouldn't really... I'm trying to think if I could pick a least favorite level. Maybe... Gosh, I want to say, like, maybe Freeze Easy Peak just because of those freaking snowmen, though. But even that level's good. I really like kind of the power scaling going on in the final boss fight, like how serious it feels, where there's so many things you have to do to her to, like, you know, get her on the ropes, and then you're not even the one who finishes her off, you know, the Jinjos have to take her out. Like, she feels really strong, and, like, you know, it kind of makes me excited for, like, whatever, like, the rematch between these characters would be, because, like, I assume in Tui the Jinjos wouldn't be there to bail you out a second time, and you'd have, like, a whole new fight.
You do a lot more work in Tui, from what I remember.
Okay. Yeah, it's really neat that, like, you're actually not the one that deals the final blow, and I do remember that, like, if you get 100%, that they do kind of state that they're making a second game, so that was planned from the beginning. It's kind of a nice, like, shonen anime arc that's built into this game.
Oh, yeah.
It's just a really fun time. There's a few things that... you know, I could complain about, which I already have, so I don't think I need to repeat myself. I guess what are you guys' thoughts on the project itself? Because you guys said thoughts on the game earlier.
Yeah, man, this was fun. I can't wait to record more in real time, like, together, physically.
Yeah, that should be our next project, actually.
Yeah, theoretically. I might be up to record stuff again soon, but I think we're gonna need a little bit of filler in between there.
We got a lot. Like, there's... I don't think you know exactly how much Wheel of Fortune we played before, like, things even went wrong. We have so much of it unposted that we've just been sitting on.
I am not surprised at this, even remotely. Yeah. But hopefully the next full project, unless it's like a one-shot or something like that, we'll be all back in person again.
Yay! I'm so excited to see you and make puns at you and see the vein throbbing in your forehead as you roll your eyes at me.
All right, so maybe the next one's not going to be in person.
Do I need to remind you how many fucking used game stores I drove you to?
Wow.
You owe me one.
I will just...
His name's Soggy?
Soggy Moggy and...
Maybe he, like, wets his pants and he, like, named his kid after that because he's a horrible parent.
He is a pretty bad parent. You haven't seen the worst of it yet, though.
Oh my god. Oh man. He was already the worst character in this game. How much worse could it possibly be? Don't answer that.
Banjo-Tooie, baby!
Yeah, maybe I'll have to play just to see how much more I can detest that human being. Or that human bearing. Ripper. That's a good name, actually.
So fun fact, I loaded up our original recording for both Furnace Fun and the final boss fight, and you did this in 50 minutes faster.
Wow!
Whoa!
With that kind of time saved at this rate, I could become a speedrunner in just 3 more playthroughs.
Yeah, you did. You definitely had to do Furnace Fun a lot more in the original run.
And
I hope we can find that footage somehow, even if we have to, like, use, like, an app to recover deleted files, because I would love for people to see how that went the first time.
Yeah, So what I was thinking is there's certain moments in this that are essentially pre-rendered where they're just cutscenes playing out. We could sync up that audio with the visuals from this recording to at least get some of those reactions in here. Because at that point, it's no difference.
I mean, that's up to you if you want to make Dan do that.
Yeah, I mean, we could do
and
that.
And do you still have the audio files for your side?
Yes.
I still have mine.
Yeah, I deleted nothing that I at least knew, if I at least knew where it was. So I held on
Boobs
to everything that I held on to everything. I could tell you're excited.
Mumbo's hiding in a tree, sorry.
It's too much for his innocent eyes.
I wonder what he's doing up there.
Hey, Mumbo got secret pictures of the girl. Nice one, Bone Brain. what's on them. Got pictures of things you missed. Secrets used in next game. Somehow I doubt that. Pictures show things you missed. Secrets that are for new game. Banjo Kazooie.
Oh, is he streaming?
Banjo Kazooie. Banjo Kazooie sounds great. Isn't it any good?
Depends who you ask. Mumbo's jaw dropped in awe.
Digger the deer, strong bait.
Aye, why isn't it called Banjo Kazooie Tooie? I better be in it too.
Well.
Oh my god, I didn't think she was in the game actually from the title. Banjo Kazooie make Banjo Kazooie look like joke. Mumbo show you pictures of stuff can use in new game. Here, take a look.
Yeah. It makes Banjo Kazooie look
Check
kinda
out my
small.
Emails!
Find first secret on beach. Hey Shorty, how'd you make that rock rise up? I asked about this. I asked if Shark Food Island was, or Sharkbait Island was like anything, and I was like, that's got a sign in it, that looks important. You're like, aha, you will learn one day, and now I have.
Someday.
Yep, this was the secret. It was meant to tie into Banjo-Tooie.
What's up there, dumb skull? I kind of wonder if maybe there would have been a way for them to have done Stop and Swap using a 64 controller pack.
Like see, that's. I think they said in hindsight they should have done that, but they wanted to do something cool that no one else had done before, which is why they went with the more risky stop and swap idea.
But they were
so far in development when Nintendo told them to stop, I guess they just didn't have the time to put towards fixing that, which is a bummer. But if you play the Xbox versions, they have fixed stop and swap. It works correctly.
Okay. I sympathize with overambition getting the better of you, so I understand. I sympathize.
Wait, we already got those
and
notes.
Like there
why
being
they
an
silly?
Obvious solution that you just don't see because you want to do something new. A nice ice key, which
cool,
you can have for free.
Giant ice key.
Hey,
yeah,
you know
that's
the
code.
Nice.
I'd like to know where to stick that.
I know where I'd like to stick that.
I know where. Okay.
Hmm.
I can't read. As evidenced by me lying my way through mandatory reading.
Maybe
I should email one of my teachers and tell her, like, hey, you almost caught me this day when you said this to me, and I was so nervous, and then when you didn't catch me, I was so relieved. I almost got caught once in seventh grade, but for third grade through eighth grade, I lied my way through mandatory reading.
I don't think they're gonna remember, and may be in your best interest to not tell them. Imagine if you emailed your teacher and they emailed back with a link to the reading you were supposed to have done.
Oh god, yeah.
I mean, they can't make me do it now. What are they gonna
they
do
can't
put
make
on my
you, but they
record?
Could set up a bot to just keep sending you that reading automatically every day for the rest of your life.
I don't think my teachers even know what bots are. They're old.
Probably really old now.
Yeah, probably.
They might have kids that know how, though.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. Sometimes I wonder how many of my teachers are still around.
Oh, wow, that's... I never realized that, huh?
What's that?
That's why he's on the jet ski. That ties into Tooie.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
It's funny, I actually just asked Jules the other day if he wants to go jet skiing with me now that I'm, like, actually, like, living for thrills.
Oh, no.
Ah, yes, living through thrills on a jet ski.
It sounds fun, and it's something...
It is fun. I have done it. It's fun.
It's something I've never done before. The end.
Just wear a life vest in case you flip.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The end. She's been buried alive and we'll never see her again.
Why did you have time to do that?
What a zany conclusion.
So zany.
Shoot, I was gonna say, actually, really quick, we're talking about teachers. I reached out to an old teacher that I really, really liked, and she told me that her and a lot of the old teachers from my elementary school are in a book club together now that they're all retired, and that's like what they do with their spare time. And she says that they talk about, like, old students that they all had, and they have talked about me. And there was one day where they decided to look me up and see what I was doing now because they all remembered me,
and they
did find my YouTube channel.
Hmm.
Nah.
It was really sweet, and she was just like, yeah, we're all so happy that, like, you found something that you love that much. And I'm just like, oh, I thought you'd all be ashamed because it didn't have enough reading in it or something, and I was just playing video games.
Well, you'd be
and they're
surprised
like, no,
that's
no.
Sweet. That's super sweet.
Yeah, they're like, no, we're just happy that you found something that you love this much. And I'm just like, I guess on Banjo Band, the best band in the world, we're gonna stop it.
I thought you meant band, like, as in canceled.
I mean, the series more or less has been canceled for 15 years, so...
Don't say that! Oh, it's still alive. Just so you guys wait.
Well, Sonic 7AM is getting a season.
People.
If Sonic 7AM is getting a season 3 animated by the fans, I don't see why this can't get a continuation.
I mean, to be fair, there are a bunch of ukulele hacks for Banjo Kazooie that are really well done.
Oh yeah, like Banjo of Time.
Yeah, that's like one of the more famous ones.
That's not what it's called, but
yep, check
maybe Jiggies
out.
Of Time or something like that.
See you next time, kiddies.
Bye, everybody.
Time. Bye.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! I can't believe you got this on the first try.
Oh my god!
This to me is actually pretty hard.
No, the Gingernado part usually is where people die.
Oh my god! Yeah, I realized, like, wait a minute, I probably better be conserving my health here, and then I was like, oh shoot, I'm down to one!
Oh wow.
Yeah, because I was realizing, like, wait a minute, this isn't as easy as I think it's going to be, because it's so many hits you have to do on it. Fingernail biting.
Well.
That last ginger has finished me, but who laughs last soon we shall see!
She missed.
Boom.
That shot is the one I told you about a couple episodes back. The one that was supposed to hit you, turn you into a toad, and then you played as 2D getting the remaining Mumbo tokens to finish the game.
I can see how that as the finale might have felt kind of long-winded, because they already do like the fake ending thing, and then you go back up and you fire and all that. Like, it would have just been a lot
of game already at that point.
What else is crazy about this is that you did that without the sandcastle codes.
Oh, really?
I've never done that. I've never done it without the sandcastle codes.
Oh, well, thank you, I guess.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
You're better than me at this now.
I don't know if I'd go that far, but, nice
would
placement
you guys like some,
watermelons.
Some melons?
Nice placement.
Risky 1000?
Oh.
I forget if they said in an interview, I might have imagined this, that they put those there because they actually had to up the rating if they had left the model as it was.
Jeez.
So they had to, like, cover it up with more stuff. So it was actually...
Wouldn't surprise me, yeah.
It was actually less sense. I don't get it, man. Like, I think that's more suggestive than if they had not done that, but... I don't know, rating boards are weird.
The other credits!
The other credits.
Yeah, the ending of this game is kind of long as it is. I can see them not wanting to make it more.
Yeah, imagine, like, what would they have done after, like, after that? Would they have done a third set, or?
It's like,
they
now
probably,
you
they
must...
would have moved this to after that, so.
Yeah, it's like, no, you must, play as bottles as he eats the carrots in Spiral Mountain! Ooh, Gruntilda will not be done until you've done that. Dude, I guess it's time to give thoughts.
Alright, how do you feel about it now that you've actually finally done it?
Oh, it's an incredible game. I still stand by the hub world being kind of confusing, but I feel like that just kind of comes as you play it more. Big butt.
Big butt.
I'm trying to think if there's like... Yeah, I like the number of collectibles in the game and what they all do. I like the number of moves you have access to. I like how there's... I keep rhyming without meaning to. I like how there's multiple ways of solving problems where you can just fly around a level that's got a flight pad and, you know, not really platform much. If you're just that good, you can swing by and pick up stuff on the flight. I like how, I kind of like just invincibility being a power-up that you have control over and it's just like a resource. I think that's an interesting idea. Some older games kind of did that. You don't see that as much nowadays. Nowadays it's like, hey, during this attack you have iframes, but that's kind of something that you have to realize and it's not really a move, you know? Let me think. I do feel like there's a lot of levels where the water hurts you, and I did kind of feel myself getting tired of that by the end. I wouldn't say that I really dislike any one level, though. Even Rusty Bucket Bay I thought was great. Clanker's Cavern a lot of people struggle on, I've heard that level's, like, really stressful for a lot of people, and I still liked it. There's just a lot of little things, like getting double health when you ground pound enemies and stuff. That crab reminded me of that. The characters are really fun. I feel almost like you could make a cartoon series out of this world and it would be really, really enjoyable. I kind of wish they'd make that happen.
Well, you never know. Hey, maybe we should make it.
Yeah, you know, with all the animating skills, it would just be like us locking Tom in a room and telling him what to do.
Except to get costumes and do like real life animation, or actually,
that's called a movie, Tim.
Yeah, okay,
that's
yeah.
That's called a movie.
Real life
he was
animation.
Coining he was coining live action as real life animation like it was a new idea.
There's like a there's an expression for that. I don't know what it is.
Rotoscoping. Yeah, is there thoughts on the project? Anybody else want to step up? I talked a lot about my thoughts on the game.
I mean, we both grew up with this game or played this game enough that we like it a lot, so.
Hell yeah. It's a masterpiece.
You
it's
did,
better than
you
Mario 64,
good.
In my opinion.
Thanks. I think I... Yeah. Aside from Rusty Bucket Bay, I think I had, like, 4 actual deaths in the actual project. I think Gruntilda got me twice, except for the one time that I jumped off the cliff on purpose. Or, no, she got me 3 times. 3 times. That's 5 real deaths, aside from Rusty Bucket Bay.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I'm with Tim, too. I like this better than Mario 64, but, I mean, this also has the benefit of, like, 2-plus years on it.
It certainly does iterate upon it a lot. It's... I remember as a kid, I always wanted another game like Mario 64, and little did I know it was here the whole time. I just tried it for 5 minutes and didn't like it.
I put this on the same level as Zelda, Ocarina of Time, probably, even though this came out before it.
That was a good year to be a gamer, though, because that was 1998 as well.
Yes, 98 was magical.
Yeah, 98 was when I first started playing games, but I largely just had Mario 64 and, like I said, Star Wars Episode 1 Racer.
Episode 1 Racer. Good lord.
Mm-hmm. Boom!
It's called a boombox! That's clever! Boss boombox.
Hell
one
yeah.
of the few boss fights in the whole game.
Yep.
They don't really do boss fights in this
Chad!
Game. Usually...
Mm-mm. They kind of
make it to your party someday, buddy.
Usually it's just enemy you can't kill, like Big Butt. I dub her Melanie.
Dude!
That was probably her production name.
That's probably actually her name? Ooh, did you hear that, Kazooie? We're going to be in another game!
This was our second one, technically, if you count Diddy Kong Racing, but okay.
Actually!
Why isn't it called Banjo Kazooie 2-y? I'd better be in it too, short stuff.
Oh my god, that was a complaint. I thought Kazooie wasn't in it because of the title. I thought they replaced Kazooie with Tootie because I thought it said Banjo Tootie.
But she's on the box!
Yeah, but that doesn't mean she's playable. She might have just been there.
Oh, the jiggies you did snatch, but I'll be back for my rematch!
One thing that I strangely know about this game is that in the Xbox version it says game over instead of the end, and it's like, wow, fuck you, game, sorry I finished
yeah,
you.
I guess so.
Speaking of game over, we never did actually show the game over cutscene.
Yeah. Shall we?
Oh.
Sure. Oh yeah, while you're loading that up, here are the cheat codes for stop and swap. Mm-hmm. You have to type in the word cheat into the Treasure Trove Cove sandcastle floor, and then you type in... Now you can see a nice ice key, which you can have for free for the ice key. Out of the sea, it rises to reveal more secret prizes for the Shark Food Island. A desert door opens wide, ancient secrets wait inside for Gobi's Valley. Don't you go and tell her about the secret in her cellar for Mad Monster Mansion. Amidst the haunted gloom, a secret in the bathroom for Mad Monster Mansion again. This secret you'll be grabbing in the captain's cabin for Rusty Bucket Bay, and now Banjo will be able to see it on Nabnut's table for Click Clock Wood.
I like the secret you'll be grabbing in the captain's cabin. That's a good one.
That's good.
Banjo's game ends in my tower. Turn it up. I need full power.
The other
yes, your grunting shh transformation soon. I don't talk that fast.
Soon be complete.
Tell me, Banjo, I feel all funny.
Baron Bird finished. Grunty wins.
Well, here we go.
I don't get why they play this for saving and quitting. That's not the same as losing. Oh wow. Oh.
Yeah, I don't know how they got away with the moaning.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mumbo falling in love with her.
Yep. Grunty dies. Come back to Mumbo's skull. Oh, wow.
Oh,
see, the moral of the story is no one likes Tootie. That's it.
Man.
That's the moral of the story. Only Banjo likes Tootie.
Yeah. So because I saw this cutscene and that was like the ending, I thought it meant that like my save data was erased and that like I could never win.
You never tried to boot it back up and look. You were just like, that's
seven.
It. I'm done.
It was like the third video game I'd ever played.
Wow.
Yeah, I thought it was like a permaloss. I didn't know that wasn't a thing.
Oh, Nintendo.
Wow. Okay, well, anyone else want to say anything?
Yeah, this game rules.
No, I think that says everything.
Yeah, it really does. This game is awesome. Like, give it a try. Even if you've watched us play through all of it, it's really enjoyable to go through. I would not mind playing this again after seeing all of it.
Oh, yeah.
And now it's portable, so you really have no excuse. Not even time.
He's a bear who wears a necklace.
Banjo Kazooie. Okay, well, I guess we'll see you guys back here next time for probably some Wheel of Fortune or something in the middle of whatever comes next.
Wow, confidence for whatever we're doing next.
We still have unposted Wheel of Fortune from before the lockdown, which is nuts.
Oh god.
Wow.
We recorded
that much of it, so you might be seeing that soon. We just wanted to jump into the next project this time, like really early, so we didn't post any of that though, but hopefully.
Yeah.
Okay. I just love that demo. Look, we missed a carrot. And he just works it in the script.
It's so good.
That got me to laugh so hard. All right, see you guys next time.
Later. Bye,